town, as they called it, pleased me the less the longer I saw it. But until our language stretches itself and takes in a new word of closer fit, town will have to do for the name of such a place as was Medicine Bow. I have seen and slept in many like it since. Scattered wide, they littered the frontier from the Columbia to the Rio Grande, from the Missouri to the Sierras. They lay stark, dotted over a planet of treeless dust, like soiled packs of cards. More forlorn were they than stale bones. They seemed to have been strewn there by the wind, and to be waiting till the wind should come again and blow them away. Yet serene above their foulness swam a pure and quiet light, such as the East never sees. They might be bathing in the air of creation's first morning. Beneath sun and stars, their days and nights were immaculate and wonderful.
West of here, coal is strip mined in Hanna. 40 miles north, the uranium pits at Shirley Basin churn out yellow cake to fuel our nuclear power plants. Employment is up, pay is high. For people like Larry Stolworthy, who have followed the mine work for most of their lives, times are good.
Working at Arch Mineral Corporation, the Seminole Mine Number 2, and work as a mechanic. Spent about half of my working life mechanicing. The first half was doing other things, driving truck, operating dozer, operating all kinds of heavy equipment, really. But a guy has a little better chance of making a working life if you get into something like mechanicing or something like that. Not too many people that move to the state of Wyoming feel like they're Wyomingites. They're just here until they can do something else. They just figure to be here for a year, 2 years, 3 years, and then they're going to make another move, you know. But the wife and I, and most of the family, I could say, in general, feel that Wyoming's our home, you know. Since we've come to Wyoming, we've had such a good life and enjoyed ourselves so much that probably the only time we'll ever leave Wyoming is after we retire. And, you know, it's too cold for old people to retire in, if you know there's something better than there is. I much prefer this type of work to anything I've ever done. You don't do the same thing 2 days in a row. Every morning when you go to work, there's always a different challenge. Some days it'll upset a guy, you know, know, of course, some days you're not feeling just up to par, and they'll give you a job that's quite nasty and out in the cold and this type of stuff, and it'll upset you, but one thing about it, you know, tomorrow's going to be a different one.
Mines open up and mines shut down. Before settling in Medicine Bow 6 years ago, Larry lived in Durango, Colorado, Grand Junction, Colorado, Cuesta, New Mexico, Farmington, New Mexico, Gillette, Wyoming, Casper, Wyoming, Shirley Basin, Wyoming, and Salt Lake City, Utah. He drove long-distance tractor trailers, worked blasting crew, hauled uranium out of Monument Valley, hauled radioactive tailings off the Colorado riverbanks to make Lake Powell safe for tourists, operated dozer, scraper, grader, and dump trucks at construction sites and open pit mines, like this one, and this one. Like thousands of other miners who would rather follow the work than get stuck when a mine closes, Larry lives in a mobile home.
Played it all the way through, and I didn't make a boo-boo.
He lives with his wife, Bonnie, and his youngest son, Don. He lives in Medicine Bow, an old ranching community and Union Pacific rail stop crowded these days with coal, uranium, and oil workers, boomers and miners, transients and 20th century settlers. Along with 100 other workers, Don was laid off from his job at Arch when the mine cut back on production. There's plenty of work in the state for heavy equipment operators, but Don will have to leave home to find it.
Since I got laid off, everything's gone to haywire. I was planning on buying a motorcycle and going on a trip to Alaska this summer. That kind of went down the tubes real quick. I've been thinking about going back to school, back to pilot school. I can go back to work, but I hate to say it, but I really don't want to go back to mining. It's kind of a drag. Heavy equipment operating. It's warm, but you sure get bored in a hurry. My dad wanted me to go to work at the mines, make big money and save a lot of cash and go to school and not have to make a loan. Well, I liked the money and I rinked and I dinked and I bought a truck and I screwed it all off, so I haven't got anything saved. I never expected this to happen. There's a lot of guys didn't expect this to happen. But I kind of look at it this way, you know, I can go to school, and if I can't make it at what I'm doing, I can always come back to this. This is always going to be here. The money's always there, and I know how to run the equipment, so I won't have any problem getting a job. I mean, like if I flop out, what the hell? I went into that job with the attitude, okay, I'm really going to work, I'm going to try my damnedest to make a lot of money and do them a good favor by hiring me. And the first week they broke me of that, boy, they don't want to be showing up at all. If you work hard, you're an enemy, okay? Third shift wasn't like that. Nobody cared how hard you worked, as long as everybody got along. On day shift, if you work hard, the guys get mad at you because you're showing them up. I mean, they don't like it, so why try? You get paid the same whether you work or don't.
Hi, man.
Most kids in the school will go out to the mines after they graduate because you make $23,000, $24,000 a year. You know, you can buy a new truck, you can buy just about anything a kid wants. Snowmobiles, motorcycles. It's pretty nice money. And you don't have to have an education for it. Any bozo can learn to run a piece of heavy equipment. I mean, they're simple, controls and stuff like that, so. I don't know, it's not much of a future, and I don't like it.
Pair nine. Pair sevens. Yeah.
I'm bored whenever I do it. I'm bored stiff running a scraper. It gets to be a real drag.
I think you could bluff him out with the bear.
But if I asked you, you know, okay, you can sit here for 8 hours and not move an inch, read a book, and get paid $13 an hour, wouldn't you do it? Hell yeah, why not?
I raised five kids in a 10 by 55 trailer. But if you got a solid home, you can live close like that. But you better be a friend, and you better be polite. Save your niceties for home, not saying excuse me to the guy on the street.
The best and the worst? The worst is the best, as far as I'm concerned, because it shows you what you can and can't take and what you can survive, can't survive. How strong you are, how independent you are, how quick you can think, and if you're willing to think, and if you don't want to think, you don't stay long. So the worst is the weather and the isolation at times, but that is the best too, because it makes you appreciate and depend on yourself and your families and get along. It forces you into stretching your abilities.